What's going on guys, this is SP Architect. In this video, we are going to be modeling details site plan. We are going to work this site plan and as you can see here, there are lots of works to do. First, we are going to get rid of these unnecessary mesh lines. After that, I'm going to show you how to show dimension these contour lines. And then we are going to learn how to make project location, true north location. And we are going to study sun settings and graphic views and working with scale in site plan. So let's get started. I want to show you how to make a site plan first. As you can see here, we have a site plan button here. If we just double click this, we can see this plan looking shape, but this is not a true plan or not a site plan because we don't see any building here. And then we see this unnecessary text and something like that. So we are going to follow a different way to do that. Okay, to do that, the first thing I'm going to do is I go to 3D. And also this is our building, which we are going to make site plan. I have 3D view options here. To activate this, you just right click here. Click this 3D visualization and then you will see this toolbar. Now I want to make this 3D view an axonometric view. To do that, I'm just going to click this axonometry and then I want to go top view. So in order to achieve that, here we have this button, look to perpendicular of clicked surface, click this and click any flat surface. We have terrace here, so I'm gonna click this. So as you can see, we have top view of this building. Actually, site plan word means that looking to your building from the sky. So why don't we use this view? Okay, we have to save this view and make this 3D view or turn this 3D view to work vector lines as plan view. So to do that, I go to this project map. Here we have this 3D documents. Right click this and click this new 3D document. I'm gonna delete this one. I'm gonna call this site plan. Create. There we go. But actually, this view has some shadings, colors, or textures. We want this to be black and white to place the layout. So, to make this black and white, I go to site plan here, right click, click the settings, and then here you can see this shaded. Let's click this uniform pan color. This determines the face of the elements, so we have to do this something like a white color or maybe this transparent. We have this transparent or window background. I'm gonna do click this transparent. Let's see what we have. Click OK. There we go. But actually these are green lines and we can turn these green lines into black lines. So I go to 3D settings again, cut elements here, not cut elements. We have this uncut surface pen, not that. Uniform pen for uncut elements. Okay, let's check up this and for the pen, I'm gonna choose a black one. Maybe we can use this 41. Click that. And vector 3D hatching. Okay. That means if you have pattern in your surface, maybe something like this tiling, for example, in your terrace, or maybe you can make grass shapes onto this mesh, but we don't have any vector 3D hatching, so I'm not going to click this. And then we can uncheck this transparency, sun shadows. Okay, I want some shadows. For the shadow polygons, 50%. Let's click this one and color. Okay, let's try this one. Click OK. There we go. I think this looks like very nice. In order to compare this one with classic ArchiCAD's own site plan, no worse here. Of course, we are going to use this one. Okay, this was the graphic view. To change the graphic view of your site plan, you are going to go to this 3D documents and you are going to change the settings. That's all. Okay, let's go to scale. Here you can see the scale. It's 1 to 100. You can change it from here. What's the difference? The view scaled down to half. But in addition to that, if I insert here a text, for example, site plan, enter, this has got an actual font size and rotation, which is 3 mm in your layout book. This is not going to be changed. So if we just go to any layout here, for example, this one, not this one. Yes. Open this. Okay. I'm gonna delete this one. Go to here. And 3D documents and site plan. Drag and drop here. Okay, there you go. You can see the site plan text. And this is 3 mm. Because this A01.1 ground floor has A2 landscape paper. And our site plan view, I'm going to right click this view settings. You can see the scale placed here as 100 scale. Let's make this 200. Click OK. The building got smaller and the text here is still the same. That's the difference. So let's close this and go to site plan. Please do not forget these settings. Take your ruler into your hand and look to millimeter into your ruler and place your text according to that. Okay, anyway, this was the scale title. So let's jump into the sun settings. To change the sun settings, we have these settings here. Sorry, not this. We are going to click this project map and click these settings. And here we have redefine 3D projections. We are going to click this one. And our camera, please do not change this. If you change this camera angle, your site plan angle will be also changed. So we are going to change this sun only. You can just click and drag, and as you can see shadow. Oops. Okay. We are going to only change this sun, and shadow is changing according to the sun positions. For the angle, we are going to change this one. Click here. Okay. Maybe let's try this one. Click OK. Okay. There we go. To get the shorter shadows, we are going to increase that value. We want this value near to the 90 degrees. Yeah. Okay, we have shorter shadows. You can just play around with the settings and experience that settings and use that in your projects. But I want this one 45 degrees. After this one, we have a question. Where is the north? This direction may be true or not. How we can determine that? The solution is in the options menu. I click options menu. Here we have project preferences and project location. Of course, you can input your settings directly from here, but manually we don't need to do that. We have time zone code, which is Stockholm, but you can change this according to your country. Okay, anyway, I can select Istanbul. And also we can use this show in Google Maps. You can get your coordinate from here and copy the settings and paste to the ARCHICAD. But anyway, I don't want to do that. Let's just leave this with Istanbul and click OK. After that, I go to options menu again, project preferences, and we are going to select this set project node, but we cannot click this because we are actually in the 3D view. So we have to go to ground floor. Let's just fix this 1 to 100. Okay. And then I go to options again, set project node. Maybe this angle. Okay. We have set the project node. What does it mean? It means that we have shadows in the site plan as in your country. Actually, these shadows are true and you can study your project in the real shadows. You can just set your living room, bedroom, and terrace vista according to these some positions in particular times. Alright then, you get the point. Let's jump to the dimensioning. To make any dimension here, you can use this dimension, text or label. We have already added a text here. And this is changing according to this scaling. And I click dimension. I click this and this marker types appeared. We can just click this. And we have additional options here. I'm gonna click this one. You can select one of these, upside or downside, and also full field or empty field. Let's click this full field. And then you just click onto your building. You click and you see the point, and then right click and click OK. For the positioning, actually, if you can see this point, here we have a point. If you click here and it's going to be created onto that point. Again, I click here, right click, OK, and onto horizontal angle, I'm gonna click in that horizontal line. Let's just get rid of that one, delete, alt click this dimension, maybe click here, right click, OK, and there we go. We have river here. And also you can make linear dimension from here and aligned or perpendicular. Let's just measure this point to this wall. Right click, OK, and click in the space, and there we go. To fix that numbering, you need to go to here, this view map. Find your site plan, right click, view settings, and plane meter. This is what we are using. We have to determine something different. So we just go to Options, Project Preferences, Working Units. Sorry, not that one. Work Project Preferences and Dimensions. Plane meter, we are in the plane meter and you can see this linear dimensions meter. Click the centimeter, 0 for the decimals and store as okay. Click okay, okay. And there we go, already it was fixed, but we have to change the settings and click our SP architect dimension settings and okay, there we go. We have our site plan, we have dimensioning, text, visualization, black white model, shadows. You can see everything into your model, rows, curves, stairs, trees, your model details and much more. You also edit the site plan into your layout plan. Alright guys, thank you for watching. If you like this, please hit the like button. And also, I'm going to add this project into my Patreon page, so you can download this project from there. Also, you can reach other project files also and other tutorials. And also, I have added a video file about how to make this project from scratch. You are going to see how I did this road, curves, this project details, how to add layers into your walls and also for the floors and much more. Alright then, see you at the next tutorial.